So let's bring in here Su-Lin Ong, Chief Economist at RBC Capital Markets in Australia. Su-Lin, great to chat to you as always. You know, what do you take from these employment numbers? Is it a warning sign that this unemployment rate has jumped in this month, or is it simply you've got to take this on a month-by-month basis at the moment?
Look, I think that's the right approach, a bit of a month-to-month basis. We did get a lift in the unemployment rate to 3.7, but since the middle of last year, it's pretty much chopped between this 3.5 to 3.7 range. So a very tight range, obviously very low by historic standards. 3.5 is about a 50-year low. So we're a little up on that, but nothing, I think, that signals any real alarm. At the end of the day, the labour market's really strong. It's really healthy, still very tight. But what we would say is we've probably seen maximum tightness. We've probably seen the lows in the unemployment rate. We don't expect it to dip below 3.5%. Probably further into the second half of this year is when it starts to creep up on a more sustained basis towards 4%.
Okay, so given the Reserve Bank review and suggestions that the new mandate for the Reserve Bank is not just going to be inflation and the well-being of Australia's economy, but also our employment, how would that change the view and the stuff that we're seeing now about where interest rates might be set into the future?
Look, I think today's labour market report, despite some weakness in the headline print, despite this lift in the unemployment rate, like I said, it's month-to-month chop, and overall it's still a really strong and healthy labour market. When you look at where the unemployment rate is, employment generation, participation and the rest. So where we are is still below full employment. We would characterise full employment somewhere closer to 4.25%, the RBA has said. So we're still a long way below that. And we can see some loosening up and weakening in the labour market, and that would still be consistent with the RBA's full employment objective. So right now, what is it not meeting? It's really not meeting its inflation target, which is why it's lifted rates and continued to hike. And there's a risk that it will still need to do a little bit more because we're still got a very healthy labour market, that full employment objective's being met. What isn't is really the very high and elevated level of inflation. So the bias is still towards possibly a bit more tightening from the bank.
OK, yeah, I get that, because I'm just trying to work it out in my mind as to where that monetary policy decision-making would go into the future. If you and I both agree that unemployment at 3.7% is below the level of full employment, which might be 4.25%, surely the bias is towards the Reserve Bank raising interest rates to try and increase the unemployment rate. What we know right now is the Reserve Bank is trying to glide the economy lower, and it will be allowing inflation to stay higher for longer to try and preserve most of these jobs. But that's almost counterintuitive, given the fact that we're not at full employment. We're well below it right now.
We are, but we also know monetary policy works with a lag. So the 11 rate hikes that we've seen that's taken the cash rate to 3.85, that still hasn't fully worked its way through the economy. And in fact, for variable rate mortgage holders, they're still only, you know, paying up to probably the interest rate hikes of 3 months ago. These are still coming through. So we know policy has got more work to do. We know that activity is starting to moderate, particularly the consumer and housing more broadly. That will ultimately lead to some weakening in the labour market and a lift in the unemployment rate. So we think that is in train. The question really, I think you're asking, Ross, is policy restrictive enough? Is it tight enough, and are rates high enough to get the unemployment rate a little bit higher? Not too much. The RBA talks a lot about walking this narrow path in terms of not tipping the economy into recession and driving a much weaker labour market. And so that's the real judgment at the moment. The risk is it still possibly, as you allude to, has a little bit more tightening to do, but we are mindful that policy is still working its way through the economy. There's a big step up coming in terms of the expiry of fixed rate mortgages and those households that will be shifting to much higher variable mortgage rates, and all of that as well will slow the economy and loosen the labour market and push unemployment a little bit higher. So all of that's coming. It's a judgment call now. And yes, the risk is maybe there is still a little bit more to do.
There's a timing thing here also, because businesses out there might well be adapting to not being able to get the workers and skilled workers and changing work practices and even changing the use of technology. But then you've got 1.5 million new immigrants coming into the country over the next 5 years. And so the timing and the economic pressures could well be brought to bear on the Australian economy over that time.
Yeah, there's a lot going on at the moment. And I think you're right to point out the big migration and population story. Clearly, that's come back faster than anyone, including the Reserve Bank and the government, anticipated. That is additive to demand. It's additive to inflation. And I think we do have to think about that in the policy context. It is helpful in some sectors where there is clear shortages of labour, and some of that offshore cohort can fill that. But across the board, we would argue on balance, it is, it does add to demand and inflation. So that needs to be calibrated into policy settings. And again, I think keeps that bias towards slightly higher rates from
Good
the
stuff.
Reserve Bank.
Su-Lin, always great to chat to you. Chief Economist at RBC Capital Markets. Many thanks for your time today.